How often do you speak to Saban? When was the last time you spoke to him?
Last time I spoke to Coach Saban was probably about 2 months ago.
Okay.
Yeah, probably about 2 months ago.
What are those conversations like?
Man, I was in Tuscaloosa, and we just caught up, and, you know, talking about the team, talking about me being in Baltimore, and just catching up, really. Nothing too crazy. Just catching up with each other. He's busy, I'm busy.
Tell me something about him I don't know before I let you go. Give me a good story from you and Saban, and because he has such, you know, he has obviously such a reputation of being a bit of a, you know, hard ass.
Yeah.
But give me something about Saban that, I mean, I hear him on Dan Patrick's show all the time, and he said that his wife once told him that he's got to lighten up and interviews and things like that. But give me a good one about Saban. Yeah.
So, man, my coach, man, you don't expect this from him, but, man, he tried to quit on me one time, man.
What do you mean?
We was in a golf tournament, did a little Chick-fil-A golf tournament, and, you know, we were in a playoff. In the last hole, 18, we were in a playoff. We played the hole like three times versus two other groups, and like we kept tying. We were driving back to the tee box. He like, man, if we tie again, he's like, I'm gonna have to probably get out of here. I got somewhere to be. I got a plane to catch. I'm like, coach, man, like we in a playoff, man. We about to win this whole tournament, man. You talking like you trying to go? He's like, I'm like, you ain't teach me that. You know what I mean? I don't know what you get that from. But anyways, We teed off on the last hole,
yes.
And we ended up losing that playoff. Uh-huh. And I told him, I said, you brought us that negative energy, man. You was talking about if we tied again that you was going to have to leave, catch the flight, leave early. And, you know, we ended up losing on that playoff hole.
Man. How did you take that? You basically accused him of bringing rat poison into this group here.
Hey, he remembers. He knows. I'm sure he'll tell you the same story. Okay. He'll justify my story. I checked him, man, and I think that kind of opened his eyes to know that, you know, you got to be accountable, man. I held him accountable as he's held me accountable several times.
You're the best, man.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.